Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name Alda Nadia Ciptaningrum. I will explain about homosexuality that occurred in animals. I agree with the topic of homosexuality in animals. Homosexual occurs in animals because there are more male population than female animals. Male animals must compete with other male animals to mate with female animals. It causes male animals prefer to gather with fellow male animals and ignore female animals. Other than that, they can also only seek pleasure and comfort that only they can feel from the same sex. But there are also those who do it precisely so that they can fertilize female animals. For example, is flower beetles. Examples of types of animals that experience homosexuality include Japanese macaca, sheep, penguins, serpents, dolphins, and even insects such as beetles and flies. Watch the following video.
So does homosexuality. Research done in the 90s and early 2000s looked at sheep's sexual orientation, as they are some of the gayest animals in the animal kingdom. As many as 1 in 10 rams can be gay and will live exclusively gay lives with only male partners, even with fertile females around. The researchers believe they found a biological underpinning for homosexuality by studying these rams' hypothalamuses. Gay rams' hypothalami, maybe, was biologically different than straight rams. Baba, they were born this way.
You know it. It's not just sheep. More than 450 vertebrates and more than 1,500 species overall engage in homosexual acts aplenty, illustrating that homosexuality isn't against nature. It's completely part of nature.
Beetles, birds, bonobos, bats,
dolphins, orangutans, macaques, and penguins.
Dragonflies, albatross, dogs and cats, even lions all exhibit homosexual behavior.
Yep, that mighty king of the jungle ain't afraid to engage in a little spooning, sporking, and even forking of the same sex.
But why? Why would nature evolve something that seems counter to evolution?
Right? If the origin of species is correct and we're all here to achieve reproductive success, allowing us to spread our genes far and wide, then why would organisms evolve not to do that? Science is still working on it.
There are a number of theories, though. Female Japanese macaques were observed mounting each other even when suitable males are around, and they hypothesize it may be a way to climb the social ladder by becoming a dominant female in a social group and thus gaining influence and resources.
Though other researchers claim that homosexual behavior could come down to something as simple as seeking pleasure, these animals are just doing what feels good. Research with giraffes found 1 in 20 would be necking with a member of the same sex at any given moment, while bonobos and dolphins are generally bisexual, but will go through phases of exclusive homosexual activity.
They gotta give it the old college try, right? But it's not just for show. Some animals sustain lifelong homosexual relationships, like penguins. Researchers from the University of Minnesota found permanently pair-bonded female-female couples raise chicks nearly as well as female-male couples. Not quite as well, but better than a single female penguin would have done. This indicates to those researchers that homosexual pair bonds may have evolved as a way to better raise young. They can even raise chicks that were fertilized by a dominant male that was separate from the pair bond without having to pair bond with that male. Benefits all around.
Totally. Roy and Silo, two male chinstrap penguins that once lived at the Central Park Zoo, had a long-term love affair that included an adoption of a chick. The two remained together for 6 years until Silo found his eyes were wandering to a newly introduced female named Scrappy.
So just because Roy shtupped Silo yesterday doesn't mean he can't get down with Scrappy today too, right?
Right?
Cool.
Yeah, if these animals can teach us something, it's that sexuality is not static or fixed, but fluid and flexible.
Thank you for watching.